In this video, we're going to look at how we change the wallpaper on our iPad. We basically have a couple of different options for our wallpaper. We can change it on the lock screen as well as on our home screen. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at how we change the wallpaper on our iPad. Let's go over to my iPad. So as I mentioned, we basically can change the wallpaper in two different spots on the iPad. We can change our wallpaper for our home screen, which is what this is here. The wallpaper is that red background that you see. Or what we can do is we can change the wallpaper for the lock screen. So when I go and lock my iPad and then wake it back up, this is the lock screen. We can see it has that red background. What we're able to do is change both of these wallpapers for the lock screen, which is right here, as well as for our home screen, which is right here. So how do we do that? Well, if we want to change our lock screen and our wallpaper for the home screen, what we do is we go to the Settings app. I'll show you how you can just change the wallpaper for the home screen in a little bit. So I'm going to go over here to my settings, where we can change both the lock screen and the home screen. So now what we need to do is we need to go to the left here and you're going to see wallpaper. This is where we're going to change our wallpaper. And basically what we have here is our lock screen is right here. And we can see it's just that red background. And then we also have our home screen. So the first thing is we can have multiple wallpapers. You're going to see that I have a number of dots here. That means that I have more than one screen or more than one wallpaper. And what I do is I swipe to the left or right to go through those different wall screens. So I'm just going to swipe and you can see I'm changing my wallpaper here. So when we go back over here, you're going to see that my lock screen here has a different wallpaper than my home screen does. And if I want to set this as current, I just tap on set as current, and now that is my current home screen. And when I go to the lock screen, you're going to see that it's that wallpaper there. So let's go back over to my settings and take another look at this. So the first thing is if you have multiple wallpapers, what you can do is you can just swipe to the left or right to go through them. And then when you're ready to set one, you just set as current. So now that we know how to switch between our different wallpapers, how do we even create a new wallpaper? Maybe I should have addressed that first. We need to create them before we change them, right? Well, if you want to create a new wallpaper, basically what you do is you tap on this here. Now, before we tap on it, we're going to have a lot of options here. And one of them is what we can do is we can pair both our lock screen wallpaper along with our home screen wallpaper. So we can pair those together so they're basically the same. That's what this is here. This is paired together. And when I swipe over to the right here, these are paired together. So let's go ahead and tap on Add New Wallpaper and see all the different options we have. There are a lot of options here. So I tap on it. The first thing that I can do is I can set what I want as my wallpaper. I can select a photo. I can also select a photo shuffle, which means that it'll change every time I tap on my home screen, or maybe it'll change every hour. I can also set it for it to be emoji. I can set it for a color, astronomy, or even weather. So let's go with photo shuffle, the second one in. That's one of my favorites. And now what I can do is I can set it to what I want to shuffle it to. On my personal iPad, I have it set to nature, cities, and then I also have some pictures of our cats, so it says pets. So what I do is I turn off people, and now what it's going to do is it's going to shuffle between featured photos that include nature and cities. So how often is it going to do this? Well, basically we can set the frequency down here. So do we want it to be hourly, or what we can do is we can set it for daily, unlock, or tap. So every hour, what it's going to do is it's going to change to a different photo. And it's going to be either on nature or cities. So let's just keep it at hourly. If I wanted to select photos manually, I could do that. I'm just going to let the iPad select them. And then from here, I just set use featured photos. And when I do that, it's going to use my featured photos. So now it is going to use my featured photos. Now what we need to do is we need to customize our lock screen. So now that we've set it what it's going to be, and this is going to change on an hourly basis, what do we want on our lock screen? First of all, we can change the clock. We can change the font. We can change the size. We can change the color. I can also change the date. And I can go and add widgets, like the weather widget. I can go and add the weather widget in here. So then when I'm on my lock screen, I can see the weather along with the time and my featured photos. If I want to change the tint of it, I can do that. We just slide to the left or right. And you're going to see that the photo doesn't change, but the tint of it does. So we can change that as well. So if you like to have just a nice black and white, that's what I have on my iPhone, is just black and white. You can go and do that, and then it'll change all the photos into black and white. If we go to the lower right-hand corner, we have some more options. I told you there's a lot of options. This is all for the lock screen. First thing is this icon here. What I can do is I can tell it not to feature this photo. So then the next time it rotates through all these photos, it's not going to feature this photo. I can also choose a photo. So if I wanted to add a photo in here, and then I can show the photo in the library. Maybe I want to edit it. I'd be able to do that. And then with this here, this is new in iPadOS 26, we have spatial effects. Basically, what we're able to do when I tap on that is set if I want spatial effects on the photo. What are spatial effects? Well, watch when I move this iPad. You're going to see that it has a little bit of a spatial look to it, almost like I'm looking into the photo. Take a look at this boat here. You're going to see that it is moving there behind the numbers. That's a spatial effect. All you do is just tap on that and it'll add spatial effects. Another thing we can do is we can add a depth effect. When I tap on this, not only can I add a depth effect, but I can also set the shuffle frequency. Remember, we have it set for an hour. Once we are done customizing this, what we do is we tap on add, and then it'll add that wallpaper for our lock screen. So we can see that it is saving here. And now what we need to do is we need to go and customize the wallpaper for our home screen. So we basically do this in two steps. We do this with our wallpaper for the lock screen, and then we do this with our wallpaper for our home screen. So it's almost done saving here. And once it's done saving, we'll go over to the home screen. And we have a few options with that. Not as many options, but we do have a few options with that. All right. First thing is we can do is we can set this as a pair, which is what I usually do. So what it's going to do is set this photo for both my home screen and the lock screen. I like to do that, so I'm going to set that as a pair. So basically I tap on the big blue button, and now it's going to pair those. Now, you don't have to necessarily do that, but I like to have them as a pair. Now what I'm able to do is I'm able to go and customize my home page. Again, we don't have as many options, but I tap on this. And first thing is I can set if I want it to be paired at all. If I don't want it to be paired, what I'm able to do is set it to be a color, a gradient, or even choose a photo, a completely different photo from the lock screen. Like I said, I like to have it paired, so I'm going to leave it at paired over here on the left. The next thing that we can do is we can blur this. I like to have this blurred so it doesn't conflict with my app icons. I can see the full picture when it's on the lock screen, but then when it's on my home screen, it just blurs it in the background. So I tap on blur and watch what happens to the background. We can see that it blurs it a little bit. I really like this. I'm going to tap on done. And the reason why I like this is it just makes my home screen easier to see. I can still see that it's part of that photo. And if I lock it, I get to see the whole photo. And then when I unlock it, it blurs that background. And now I can easily see those app icons. So that's why you may want to blur it. So that's how we can set our wallpaper for the lock screen and our home screen. Basically, we just go into our wallpaper settings, and then from here, I can go and add new wallpaper. I can set it for a specific photo or featured photo or weather, a lot of different options in there. And then from there, we can customize it for our lock screen as well as for our home screen. And I like to keep them paired. So that's basically how we do that. And then from here, once we add our new wallpaper, we can easily switch between them. Now, what about removing? How do we remove a wallpaper or a wallpaper pair? Well, to do that, what we have to do is we have to go to the lock screen. So I'm going to lock my iPad. And if I wanted to edit this or remove this, I tap and hold while it's in the lock screen. And now you're going to see that not only can I customize it, but if I wanted to remove it, I swipe up. And now I can remove it. I tap on the trash icon and it'll remove that wallpaper. I can easily switch between all of my different wallpapers just by swiping, and if I wanted to add a new one, I could also add a new one from here. When you are done, you just swipe up, and now it's applied any changes to it. So I'm going to swipe up to get to our home screen. So that's how we can customize our lock screen along with our home screen. Now, if you just want to customize your home screen, we do have a new option with iPadOS 26. What we need to do is we need to go into the jiggly mode. So I tap and hold in this area here or on an app icon. It really doesn't matter. We just tap and hold until the apps start jiggling. Then what we do is we go up to edit here in the upper left-hand corner. And you're going to see we have the option to edit our wallpaper. This is only going to edit the wallpaper on the home screen. It has nothing to do with our lock screen outside of stopping it from being paired. You're going to see that paired has a white circle around it. That means it's paired with my lock screen. If I don't want it to be paired with the lock screen, what I'm able to do is select on color, gradient, or photo, and then change the photo. And this will only affect my home screen wallpaper. And then if I want to remove the blur, I tap on blur here, and it'll remove that blur. So now when I tap on done, you do need to tap on done. If you just swipe up from the bottom here, it is not going to save the changes. So you don't want to do that. You need to tap on done. When I tap on done, now we can see that it is no longer blurred. I like it to be blurred, so I'm going to go back into there, edit, edit wallpaper, blur, and then done. So that is how we edit our wallpaper on the iPad. We basically have two options with this, or I should say we have two different places for our wallpaper, the lock screen and our home screen. And we compare those two together. With the lock screen, we have a lot of different options. We can add widgets, we can tint it, we can even have it switch between different photos or through the weather. The way that you modify this is by going through the settings app and then going to wallpaper. From there, you're able to edit your current wallpaper, either the lock screen or your home screen, or you can go and add new wallpaper and then just go and set all the settings. You can also do this from the lock screen. Just tap and hold when you're looking at the lock screen, and then you're going to be able to make any changes to the lock screen as well as create new wallpaper for that lock screen. And then if you just want to change the wallpaper for your home screen, you just tap and hold until you get into the jiggly mode on the home screen. And then from there, you go to edit in the upper left-hand corner, select wallpaper, and then from there, you're going to be able to change your wallpaper for your home screen. It won't affect your lock screen at all. So those are the different ways we can change our wallpaper on the iPad. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, I also have a couple of different options where you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. The first one is danstutorials.com. This is a membership-based website, and not only do I have more videos there than I have on YouTube, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. When you become a member, what I'll do for you is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You have access to that AI assistant, and you have access to my classes and webinars. If you don't like a subscription or you don't want to become a member, I also have Dan's online courses. Now, this is not a membership-based site, but it is a course-based site. So what you do is you buy a course, and this is a one-time purchase. You get all the videos for that course. As of this recording, I have one course on there for the iPhone, but I plan on including another course on the iPad, which includes this video as well as more, and then eventually I'll have one on the Mac there. Check out Dan's online courses for more information on. With either one of these options, you are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So if you become a member of Dan's Tutorials or you buy a course through Dan's online courses, you are helping support my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com as well as Dan's online courses for more information. And thanks for watching.